We are going to discuss the first question. Why was Giovanni unable to avoid Beatrice? Or discuss the character of Giovanni in the story, Rappaccini's Daughter. Now, Giovanni, he was the protagonist of the story. Protagonist means the main character. The story revolves Giovanni and around Giovanni and Beatrice. He is the protagonist of the story, the main character. He is a handsome young man who has come to Padua for studying medicine in the University of Padua. He has come from Naples, the south of Italy, and he is young, handsome. He's good looking. We come to know it through the story. And the moment he enters his apartment, his accommodation, it is a ill lighted room. He peeks out of his window and notices a beautiful garden beneath the window, which is full of different kind of plants. Soon he notices Beatrice, and he's attracted to her on the very first sight. It is attraction at first sight. Mind it is just attraction so far. And he cannot help thinking about her. He is so absorbed and focused. All his focus is on her. The moment he notices her the very first time, he cannot get the girl out of his mind. He keeps on thinking about her. He tries hard, although he tries hard not to look out of the window once, but he is totally bewitched by her beauty. He finds her very beautiful, very attractive, and somewhat mysterious. So although he is an eyewitness of Beatrice's poisonous body, he notices a butterfly-like insect flying about her and who dies because of Beatrice's breath. He sees that the only reason for the death of that insect could be Beatrice's breath. The insect dies. He even notices that that Beatrice's father, Rappaccini, is very careful in dealing with the poisonous plants. Her father wears gloves and tries to avoid the breath of those plants, whereas Beatrice does not need any kind of protection. And he is an eyewitness of Beatrice's poisonous nature. And also he had received warnings from Professor Baglioni, who is his father's old friend, but still, he already knew it. Even before meeting Beatrice, he was an eyewitness of her poisonous nature. He had received warnings from Baglioni, but in spite of all this, he had a longing to meet Beatrice. After especially receiving a warning from Baglioni and coming to know about her poisonousness, still he buys flowers on his way back home, and then he glances out of the window on returning to his apartment, and when he sees Beatrice downstairs, down underneath, he throws those flowers at her. He was the one who initiated the conversation. He was the one who was speaking out of the window and looking at her, and he is the one who was an eyewitness. He knew everything from the very start, but despite of everything, he had a longing for meeting with Beatrice. He enters the garden secretly with the help of old lady Elisabetta, who is the caretaker of his room, and a series of meetings start between Beatrice and Giovanni. They keep their meetings. They keep on meeting. There's the first meeting, the second, the third, fourth, fifth, and a series of meetings start. And what he discovers about Beatrice is that she is a simple, innocent girl. And then during those meetings, once we have read in the story, he met Professor Baglioni. But Giovanni was deliberately trying to avoid Professor Baglioni. He wouldn't want to hear any kind of negative comment about Beatrice. He does not want to listen anything negative about Beatrice or Dr. Rappaccini, and he tries deliberately to avoid the company of Professor Baglioni. And the way he interacts with Professor Baglioni, we notice that he has an element of pride in his nature. And the result of those continuous meetings is that the transfusion of poison takes place, Givani himself becomes poisonous. He also inhales the poison of those plants, and he himself becomes poisonous. And then one day, Professor Baglioni gives a sudden surprise meeting to Givani, and then he offers him an antidote. He tells him that his beloved Beatrice has been is a poisonous lady, and that this antidote would serve as a cure for that poison, because this antidote can kill the strongest poisons, even the strongest poisons. So he offers him a remedy, a cure, in his last meeting. And then what happens, when Givani discovers that he himself has been poisoned, he himself is possessing poisonous qualities, finds out that he himself has become poisonous, he accuses Beatrice, and he utters very bitter, very poisonous words. We can see that he says, do you pray? Cried Givani, still with the same fierce anger. Your very prayers are, as they come from your lips, fill the air with death. Now he has been uttering very terrible, very harsh, very bitter words. An accursed one, cried he, and you have cut me off likewise from all the warmth of life, and drawn me into your region of unspeakable terror. So he utters such bitter words, which are unbearable for Beatrice. So there, when writing his character sketch, you have to quote words, sentences from the passage in inverted commas. And he offers Beatrice the antidote without thinking, and without any regard, what would be the effect of this antidote. He offers her the antidote, and she who is already hurt deeply, she is ready to undergo that experiment, and she is the first one to drink that antidote and ultimately die as a result. We find his character to be selfish, proud, and lusty as well. He was not, his feelings cannot be called love. He had a great attraction for her, for her beauty. He wanted to be close to her, he wanted to meet her, to touch her, and he was just attracted towards her beauty. I do not think there were any strong feelings of intimacy, care, affection. The way he blames her, the way he accuses her, this all indicates his dual nature. Outwardly handsome and good-looking Givani is a very bitter person inside.